Hi, this is Michael Canellis of OSIsoft, and we're at the 2017 EMEA Users Conference, and I'm speaking to Tim Alosi from Biogen. Tim, could you give us just first of all an overview of what Biogen does?
Sure, Michael. Biogen is a life sciences company, and we focus on neurodegenerative diseases. And one of the challenges you have is biologics processes are inherently variable. So our goal with next generation manufacturing is not just to reduce the variability of what comes into our process, but then we want to change the process in a robust and reliable way using some advanced control in order to adjust it so that we can react to variability of what's coming in that will give us an improved performance on what comes out. And then we're also working along the cost lines to eliminate all kind of manual activities and time that it takes for us to do quality reviews and testing.
Logging data and things like that.
Yeah, all those things are very manual activities in many of our plants today. So by integrating in our systems, we are reducing that manual activity. And of course, human power is a big element of our cost equation.
Now, what's PI's role in this?
That's a great question because, you know, we've used OSI PI throughout, you know, for many, many years, 10 or 15 years at all of our manufacturing facilities, and traditionally it's been more of a regulatory data storage, right? But we're really trying to change that this with our plant now and make PI a centralized source of truth, and not just for our sensor data, right, our temperatures, pressures, but also the context around how our process ran. So what kind of steps were run, what kind of responses did an operator enter into the manufacturing system.
So you can compare like day to day or certain batches?
Yeah, day to day, batch to batch, unit to unit. Really we're looking at not just the tag data, but and not just the asset framework, which organizes our data by bioreactor or by vessel, but also creating context along the time axis using event frames. And it's a very critical element of our implementation. By pulling all of this together, we can then expose that data to other systems in a much more consistent way because everything has a consistent context, and then that allows us to use this for advanced control, process optimization,
further fine-tuning and like...
Yeah, exactly.
How is it going to be changing the next 10 years with digital transformation and big data? I mean, I can see a lot of... Are we going to see very fundamental and drastic changes, or is this more of an evolution?
We're seeing a shift now to really embrace analytics and modeling to help us guide our process in real time, right? So a lab test may take a day or 2 days, and that's too late to then react to something that's going on in the process. And if we can embrace the use of predictive analytics, then we can get that feedback much quicker, respond much better, either save a batch, improve quality, improve yield, and that's really what we see as the next few years.
Yeah, you're fixing and recovering versus it's like...
Yes, instead of testing it at the end and determining if it's good or bad, we can actually hopefully make meaningful decisions at the shop floor in real time in order to drive our batch towards a better performance.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Michael. It's been a pleasure.